Hey guys, how's it going? Today, I'm proud to present to you 2015 brand new Toyota Hilux. And this is going to be a full in-depth tour of this Hilux. We'll start up, show the engine, go on some performance details, show you a bunch of interesting features inside and out. And so, here's the key, very elegant key. Let's start the engine. Let it run for a while. Lock, unlock. Very simple. And also, this car comes equipped with a smart key access system. Right now, the car is unlocked. Combo handles to lock it. Tap this button once. And unlock. Press once again. Very simple. Solid doors, very wide opening. It's almost like 90 degrees, providing easy entry and exit. This car has 9 airbags, including driving airbag, black leather interior, awesome seats, not bad indeed, very convenient running boards, solid doors, 3-spoke design steering wheel, leather wrap, multifunction controls side to side, grips up top, fake neutron. Alright guys, we know how to start the engine, put the foot on the brake and then hit button start. Very nice startup, Hilux. This truck comes equipped with hydraulic assist sports steering companion, very fluid steering wheel, horn. Alright, manual tilt and telescopic to adjust this lever right there. It's quite easy to adjust the steering wheel. This car has automatic lights. Right now, let's send headlight, front rear fog lights, high beam, soul service lights. Mirrors, left and right. They also heated, by the way, huge mirrors. Very good visibility. Power folding, of course. Very convenient feature, especially in tight parking spaces. Awesome. Power window lock. Your central lock. Chrome door handles. All four windows in this car are fully automatic in both direction, up and down, front. And here, not bad. All right, guys. And here's your warning right there. Rear differential lock. So Russian specification. As you can see, power heat right there. Cup holder. For the driver and for the passenger, of course, right there. Fuel cap release and hood release. Alright, guys, let's take a bit like a big stir with this truck. Four max window frames. Back windows are fully tinted, as you can see, right across the glass. Nice looking taillights. Rear view camera. Third brake light, Hilux, rear parking assist, license plate lights, single exhaust, you have a spare tire kit underneath, top hat right here, mat flaps, Hilux. beautiful rims, as you can see, 18-inch, tires measuring 265-60, rear drum brakes. LED turn signal, yes, and steering wheels, from trim. Highlights, heated windshield wipers, this area. LED daytime running lights. Headlight pushers right here. Halogen fog lights. Chrome lights there. Huge tire emblem. This truck has inline 4, 16-valve, dual head cam, 2.8-liter turbocharged diesel engine. It produces 177 horsepower, maximum speed of 175 km/h. 0-6 time is 11.4 seconds. Combined consumption for this car is around 8.5-liter per 100 km. The car is four-wheel drive. The fuel tank is around 80 liters. Alright guys, right now, take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part. Two-tone door panels, fake open room, as you can see, very nice. Twitter's right there. Soft leather armlet, white stitching, high glass black finish. Speakers right there, your bottom pillar and storage, door lights. Toyota, as you can see, your tire pressure. Driver's seat has power adjustment, sliding, seat high, and incline. Seats are very nice, very supportive, just with headrests and seat belts. Driving the airbag is right there. Fuel cap release. Alright guys, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Quite easy to read gauges. Smith engine, very torquey diesel, not good. Awesome, just awesome. And here's your light indicator controls. Intimate vibe controls right there, your audio controls on the steering wheel, you can raise and lower the volume, your different settings right there, hold to mute, your different modes, voice commands. Right now, voice recognition is not available, as you can see. On hook and off buttons for the telephone, cruise control right there, set the speed, it's quite easy. Driver information system for errors, OK button, back button, main menu, and as you can see, alright. I'm gonna change language. Yep. Alright. measure current fuel economy after reset. Right now it's not correct. Range. Eco-indicator, start, stop, so on and so forth. Very clear graphic. Consumption after reset. Not bad indeed. Your audio information. No messages. Your settings. Language. You can choose your language. As you can see, then units. Eco mode. On and off. Driver information. Pop-up display. Color. You can change the color. Eco saving, including currency. Fuel price. And back to factory settings. Nope. That's pretty much it for this display. Very comprehensive system. Overall, build quality and all the materials are very nice. You can find hard touch and soft touch plastic, chrome trim, digital clock up top, settings, as you can see, infotainment screen, audio off, disclosure right there, e-checked, volume, setup, general settings. As you can see, you can choose your language, volume settings. Very nice system to use. Then display settings, camera, you can choose brightness, contrast, audio, bass, treble, balance and fader. Bluetooth settings, it's pretty much self-explanatory, and your phone settings. That's pretty much it for setup, car. You can see your basically average fuel consumption, update, clear, media, map and navigation is not available right now. Overall, very comprehensive system indeed. Passenger back indicator right there. Four-wheel drive settings, four-wheel drive low, down here you can find your very easy to use, single zone, fully automatic climate control, you can adjust your temperature, one touch automatic, off, front your defrost, source heated exterior mirrors, your different phones, facing etc, recycle and vent, air conditioning, fan speed control. Very easy system to use indeed. Partlets right there. Locking of the rear differential. Right there. Downhill assist, turn off the traction control. Heated seats, one stage for the driver. And for the passenger, auxiliary and USB integration right there. Storage area, two cup holders. Eco mode, power mode. Eco basically helps you to save fuel. Six-speed automatic transmission. Sport mode and manual shifting, plus for the upshift and minus for the downshift. Rear view camera with guidance lines. Very nice indeed. Very reliable transmission, source engine. Quality brake, storage area, soft leather wrap center console. 100 watt AC right there. Everything is very nice put together here. You can definitely feel this Japanese quality, Toyota quality. Very good visibility. With my 6'3" stature, those seats are very nice for me. Legroom is more than enough. Thigh support is pretty good. Shoulder room is okay. Manual rear view mirror. That's for the aftermarket alarm. Door sunglass container. It's also bed. Map lights up top. Microphone hands-free. Car holder right there. Any warning? It's all Russian specification. Handles are stationary. And you can find vanity mirror and warning on the passenger side. Not bad indeed. Alright guys, let's check the back seats, shall we? Here's your fuel cap, holder right there, diesel. Child safety locks. Same two-tone panels. Soft leather wrap armrest. Storage and speakers. Back seats are very roomy, adjustable headrest, child seat anchors right there. My 6'3" stature, quite easy to get in and out. Storage bucket and grocery hooks right there and right there. As you can see, center tunnel, your armrest, soft, seat cup holders. Card hook up top, very good back visibility, and of course your map lights, illumination, interior illumination. Awesome interior in my opinion. Alright guys, let's check the rest of the vehicle, shall we? You can find manual adjustment for the passenger seat, recline, and sliding. Cup holder. Storage on top. It's not lockable. Cool via air conditioning, I believe. Lockable glove box. It's also damn. Very good size. Infusion manuals right there. Awesome truck inside and out. Love it, just love it. Well guys, hope you enjoy my entire plug. This 2015 Toyota Hilux. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. We should catch up next time. This is where it came from. Thanks for watching and take care guys. Get right there. Four-wheel drive settings. Four-wheel drive low. Down here you can find your very easy to use single zone, fully automatic climate control. You can adjust your temperature, one touch automatic, off, front your defrost, also heat exterior mirrors, your different phones, facing etc, recycle and vent, air conditioning, fan speed control. Very easy system to use indeed. Partlets right there, locking of the rear differential. Right there. Downhill assist, turn of the traction control. Heated seats, one stage for the driver and for the passenger. Auxiliary and USB integration right there. Storage area, two cup holders. Eco mode. Power mode, eco basically helps you to save fuel. Six-speed automatic transmission, sport mode, and manual shifting, plus for the upshift and minus for the downshift. Rear view camera with guidance lines. Very nice indeed. Very reliable transmission, source engine, quality brake, storage area, soft leather wrap center console, 100 watt AC right there. Everything is very nice put together here. You can definitely feel this Japanese quality, Toyota quality, very good visibility. With my 6'3" stature, those seats are very nice for me. Legroom is more than enough. Thigh support is pretty good, shoulder room is okay, manual dim rear view mirror, that's for the aftermarket alarm, door sunglass container, it's also bed, map lights up top, microphone with hands free, car holder right there, and your warning, it's all Russian specification, handles are stationary, and you can find vanity mirror and warning on the passenger side. Not bad indeed. Alright guys, let's check the back seats, shall we? Here's your fuel cap. Holder right there, diesel. Child safety locks. Same two-tone panels. Soft leather wrap armrest. Storage and speakers. Back seats are very roomy, adjustable headrest, child seat anchors right there. My 6'3" stature, quite easy to get in and out. Storage bucket and grocery hooks right there and right there. As you can see, center tunnel, your armrest, soft, seat cup holders. Card hook up top, very good back visibility, and of course your map lights, illumination, interior illumination. Awesome interior in my opinion. Alright guys, Let's check the rest of the vehicle, shall we? Here's your light indicator controls, intermittent wiper controls right there, your audio controls on the steering wheel, you can raise and lower the volume, your different settings right there, hold to mute, your different modes, these commands. Right now, voice recognition is not available, as you can see. Unhook and off buttons for the telephone, cruise control right there, set the speed, it's quite easy. Driver information system for errors, OK button, pack button, main menu. As you can see, alright. We're gonna change language. Yep. Alright. And here's your current fuel economy after reset. Right now it's not correct. Range. Communicator, start, stop, so on and so forth. Very clear graphic. Consumption, after reset, not bad indeed. Your audio information, no messages, your settings, language, you can choose your language. As you can see, then units, eco mode, on and off. Driver information, pop-up display, color, you can change the color, eco saving, including currency, fuel price, back to factory settings. Nope. That's pretty much it for this display. Very comprehensive system. Overall, build quality and all the materials are very nice. You can find hard touch and soft touch plastic, chrome trim, digital clock up top, settings, as you can see, infotainment screen, audio off, disclosure right there, e-checked, volume, setup, general settings. As you can see, you can choose your language, volume settings. Very nice system to use. Then display settings, camera, you can choose brightness, contrast, audio, bass, treble, balance and fader, nice, Bluetooth settings, it's pretty much self-explanatory, and your phone settings. That's pretty much it for setup, car. You can see your basically average fuel consumption, update, clear, media, map and navigation is not available right now. Overall, very comprehensive system indeed. Passenger awakening. Rear view camera, third brake light, Hilux, rear parking assist, last brake lights, single exhaust, your spare tire gate underneath. Flaps, Hilux, beautiful rims, as you can see, 18-inch, tires measuring 265-60, rear drum brakes, LED turn signal, yes, and steering lights, chrome trim. Hilux, heated windshield wipers, this area. LED daytime running lights. Headlight pushers right here. Halogen fog lights. Chrome lights. Huge. This truck has inline 4, 16-valve, dual head cam, 2.8-liter turbocharged diesel engine. It produces 177 horsepower, maximum speed of 175 km/h. 0-6 time is 11.4 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 8.5 liter per 100 km. The car is four-wheel drive. The fuel tank is around 80 liters. Alright guys, right now, take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part. Two-tone door panels, fake wooden entrance, as you can see, very nice. Twitter's right there. Soft leather panels, white stitching, high glass black finish. Speakers right there, your bottle holder and storage, door lights. Toyota, as you can see, your tire pressure. Driver seat has power adjustment, sliding, seat high and incline, seats are very nice, very supportive, just with headrests and seat belts. Driving airbag is right there. Fuel cap release. Alright guys, let's see what kind of noise this engine can use. Quite easy to read gauges. Hey guys, how's it going? Today I brought to present to you 2015 brand new Toyota Hilux, and this is gonna be full in-depth tour of this Hilux. We'll start up, show the engine, go inside and performance details, show you a bunch of interesting features inside and out. And so here's the key, very elegant key. Let's start the engine, let it run for a while, lock and lock, very simple. And also, this car comes equipped with a smart key access system. Right now, the car is unlocked. Combo handles to lock it. Tap this button once. And unlock. Press once again. Very simple. Solid doors, very wide opening. It's almost like 90 degrees, providing easy entry and exit. This car has 9 airbags, including driving airbag, black leather interior, awesome seats. Not bad indeed. Very convenient running boards. solid doors, 3-spoke design steering wheel, head wrap, multifunction controls side to side, grips up top, fake on neutral. Alright guys, in order to start the engine, put your foot on the brake and then hit button start. Very nice startup. Hilux. This truck comes equipped with hydraulic assist supported steering companion, very fluid steering wheel, horn. Alright, manual tilt and telescopic to adjust this lever right there. It's quite easy to adjust the steering wheel. This car has automatic lights. Right now, let's send the headlight, front rear fog lights, high beam, soul service lights. Your power mirrors, left and right. They also heated, by the way, huge mirrors. Very good visibility. Power folding, of course. Very convenient feature, especially in tight parking spaces. Awesome. Power window lock, your central lock, chrome door handles. All four windows in this car are fully automatic in both directions, up and down, front and rear. Not bad. Alright guys, and here's your warning right there. Rear differential lock, so Russian specification. As you can see, power heat right there. Cup holder for the driver and for the passenger, of course, right there. Fuel cap release and hood release. Alright, guys, let's see if you get like a big stir with this truck. Four nice window frames. Back windows are fully tinted, as you can see, right across the glass. Nice looking taillights.